Today we're going to talk about how to install the TMC2209 with N-stops as sensors. So before I did this tutorial to explain how to do it for the UART mode and sensorless homing, so this is going to be slightly different. I'm not going to cover everything I covered in the previous one by showing you where it is in the manual, but I will show you where the actual UART jumper needs to go. And it's these two pins right here in red. So I'm gonna lift this up and I'm gonna place this on those two pins right down in here and apply a little bit of pressure. So you can see that those pins are now jumped. Also, I have already the cooling fins on this, and I will use a cooling fan in an actual configuration in one of the tutorials in my playlist to show you how to activate it. But as you can see, there's red on one side, black on the other. So I'm going to plug this in like so. And then, of course, we're going to connect the NEMA stepper motor right here. I'll center this. Now we need to figure out the actual end stops. So currently we have our extruder end stop, our X end stop, our Y end stop, and our Z end stop. So we need to look up what that looks like. So what we're going to need to do is go over to the pinout diagram on the desktop here for Bigtree Tech. And as you can see, I just showed you where these are on the actual pinouts, but then you can see the pinout locations for voltage, ground, and signals. So the one that we're interested in is the voltage, ground, and PC0 for the X end stop. So let's go back over to the desktop for a second. And as you can see, we have green right here on the wiring. Then we have black and we have red. So it's actually signal. The black is actually ground and the red is voltage. So I'm going to plug it in like so, and I'll show you what that looks like, and I'll place this back down. Next, what we need to do is actually power this up. So it's going to take a second. Once this is powered up, what we'll have to do is actually examine what's going on in the actual configuration file. But it will boot a lot quicker because we have the actual eMMC on the CM4 module. So let's take a look at that. So as you can see right here, what we have going on is the actual fluid environment. So first thing we need to do is actually examine the end stops because we have it connected. So I'm going to scroll down to the console for a second. I'm going to type M119 for the G code to check the status of the end stops and press enter. And as you can see, they all say triggered. So we're going to actually have to fix that. So we're going to click on the actual configuration, then printer.config, and we're going to scroll down to the X stepper here. As you can see, the end stop is going to be, let's see, right down here, PC0 that we checked before. So I'm going to have to put an exclamation point in front of that to negate it or cause it to be the opposite of what it is. So if it was true, it would be false. But in this case, it's false, so we're making it true. So I'm going to hit save. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back over to the environment. I'm going to go back to the console over here and type M119 to check it. So as you can see, it says open. So now if I enable it with my finger and I do the command again, it now says triggered. So it's functioning correctly. So let's go back into the configuration file and we're going to set up the actual environment for the TMC. So let me show you this real quick. Over in here, we can click on the actual configuration and then configuration reference down in here. And we can actually check to see what our reference configuration is. So we have the TMC2209. As you can see, the uncommented portions are the ones you need. The ones with comments are already defaulted. So we're going to need the run current. And then, of course, there's one other one in here for Stealth Chop. So there's an actual configuration that we have to set for this so that we can use Stealth Chop. So I'll show you that in just a second as well. So let's go back over here. Find that configuration at the bottom of the file in here because they've already included part of it. I'm going to copy that. Then I'm going to go up here and I'm going to paste it right underneath so we can see it. So to uncomment this, you're going to hit the Control/ to remove the comments. And I'll tell you what these are. First of all, we have the label that says that it's the X stepper. Then we have the actual UART pin. This is the address being PB12 for the signal pin to address the actual stepper. Then we have run current. So now that we know that, we're all set for this particular part of the configuration. So we'll click save and we'll see what happens that goes wrong because there will be things that go wrong. So we'll click over here and we're gonna actually home it again. So I'm going to click on the home and test it with this. So as you can see, there's an actual error that occurs here on the desktop that we need to, that says no trigger on X after full movement. So we're missing a setting. So let's go back over here. And down in here, we have to add something. So what we need to actually add, I'll show you in just 2 seconds here. And that is homing retract distance. So I'm going to place this in here. And I'm going to leave it 0. Otherwise, it won't work. So we'll hit save and restart. We'll go back over to here. We'll close this. And I'm going to move the actual axis back so you can see it. So over here, and then I'm going to place my finger over this again to actually home it. So let's click home. And that error is now gone. Now what we need to figure out is why it's going in the wrong direction, but I showed you that in a previous tutorial, so I'll let you figure that out by watching the one for sensorless homing that'll be in the playlist in the description. But I want to set the Stealth Chop issue to rest. So essentially there's one more setting that we have to set, and it's Stealth Chop Threshold. So I'm going to go in here. Hang on a second. Sorry about that. Then I'm going to click on the printer config and I'm going to find our actual setting over here and I'm going to paste right here. So this is set to spread cycle at the moment. So we'll remove the one and we'll go 99999 and that will put us in Stealth Chop mode. So we'll save. And then we'll go back over here to test it real quick. So I'm gonna move this back over to the center, put my thumb over this again, and home it. Now obviously you can't tell what the difference is by sound right now, but that is going to be significantly quieter than running it in spread cycle mode. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And to my patrons and the people that donate on PayPal, I'm obviously grateful because you make these tutorials possible. So if you're interested in doing that, there is an actual link in the description of the video where you can do that. And you also get an early look at videos that I actually make. So that'll give you a little bit of a head start if you want to see them before they're released. So I'll place a thank you note at the end of this tutorial. Everyone, take care, be safe, and I'll talk to you later.